We'll look into the other options of this question, that is debt service obligation. What is this debt service obligation? Debt service obligation is nothing but the cash required to pay back. It is something like a very simple term, that is the cash required to pay back the principal and the interest both of the outstanding debt for a time period, basically for 1 year. So this cannot be the right answer for the commercial bank providing the credit to the government. So we know liquidity adjustment facility is something like which is related to adjustment of the requirements in terms of quantitative, that is the repo rate and also the RRR. So RR and RRR comes under liquidity adjustment facility. These are something with respect to the banks and the RBI. So this term, that is statutory liquidity ratio, which what I have already explained, which talks about the mechanism which is related, which is between the banks and also the government, because basically there may not be the much role of RBI with respect to SLR, because SLR is majorly kept with the banks itself. So within this banks, as part of NDTL, that is net demand time liabilities, we park SLR in terms of cash, in terms of gold, and also in terms of government securities. As I've already explained, the government securities are those securities which have been parked with the banks and the credit has been provided to the government on behalf of holding this government securities. So this is something like you are giving credit to the government and government is depositing this government securities with the banks. So this is the term. Which of the following terms indicates the mechanism used by the commercial banks for providing credit to the government? So this is simple example which will clearly talk about the statutory liquidity ratio holds the government securities and the banks providing credit to the government. So this fourth is the right option. We'll take another question. In the context of the Indian news in the recent times, the following, that is MCXSX, is related to what? MCXSX is nothing but multi commodity exchange, stock exchange. So this is related to the stock exchange. This is a very direct question. It cannot be related to supercomputers, moon impact probe, or the nuclear powered submarine. We'll study about what is this MCXSX. So this is something like India's third stock exchange. This is something like India's third stock exchange. So we have other stock exchanges, like the oldest one, that is the Bombay Stock Exchange. The other one like National Stock Exchange, and the third one is the MCXSX, which is nothing but Multi Commodity Exchange Stock Exchange, which is a subsidiary of MCX. We can say it is a subsidiary of MCX, and it also has an index, that is the flagship index which is a part of MCXSX is SX40. SX40 is the subsidiary, that is the index of SX40 is the index of MCXSX. Recently the term MCXSX has been renamed as Metropolitan Stock Exchange. So you need to remember, as part of your prelims exam, that is MCXSX, which was the earlier name, has been renamed to Metropolitan Stock Exchange. So this is basically which deals with the exchange of shares, commodities, equities, derivatives, etc. So you have to remember what is this MCXSX and what is this rename version of the new version of MCXSX and what is this index, that is SX40. We'll take the next question, that is during the which 5-year plan was the emergency clamped and the new elections took place and the Janata government came into power. So here the clause here is new elections took place and the Janata party was elected. Look, there is a small hint which you should remember with respect to the 5-year planning is third plan, fifth plan and seventh plan. So after third plan we have 3 years of gap, after fifth plan we have 2 years of gap, after seventh plan we have 2 years of gap. So this third plan, there was a break of 3 years. This is majorly due to droughts and also the war that India has faced with China and Pakistan. And after fifth plan, there was a break of 2 years. This was basically due to political crisis. So political crisis was the reason why we have to take a break of 2 years after this fifth plan. And there is an emergence of a new government, that is a Janata government, which is headed by the Morarji Desai. So right answer for this is fifth plan. So you just remember this logic, which is 5th, 3rd, 5th and 7th. It's very simple to answer these questions. We'll take another question. Which of the following is treated as artificial currency? So there's a term which is given as artificial currency. So what is this artificial currency and what is the answer for this artificial currency? So the term artificial currency is related to SDR. So C will be the right answer. So what is this SDR? SDR is nothing but special drawing rights. What is the special drawing rights? Special drawing rights is something like a basket which has a bunch of currencies, majorly this dollars, yen, pound, renminbi and euro. So this is a basket with a group of currencies which has a value which will be calculated in terms of dollar, and every country has certain right to claim from IMF. So special drawing rights are related to IMF, and also we can call it as an artificial currency. So ADR is nothing but American Depository Receipts. GDR is nothing but Global Depository Receipts. So ADR and GDR are related to the market system, that is the money market system, where investments are being raised from American institutions, or investments are being raised from those institutions which are apart from US. This is GDR. But the question talks about the artificial currency, which is related only to SDR, that is special drawing right. Or you can also answer it as this is the term which is directly related to IMF, that is International Monetary Fund. Thank you.